Hey guys, what's going on? Chad here, and I'm bringing you guys another MapleStory video. And about 2 or 3 weeks ago, somebody asked me to do another equip video, and I said I would, but I apologize that I have not gotten around to it in such a long time. But anyway, in this video, I want to go into a little bit more detail, and what I mean is that I'm going to still show you guys my equips and range like normal, but I'm also going to show you guys things like my inner abilities, my character cards, my link skills, etc. So if I'm forgetting anything, please let me know in the comments below, and I'll try to show that in the next equip video. But anyway, without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. So first things first, my range. Unbuffed, my range is 100k to 111k. And let's go ahead and find a ladder here so that I can buff up. Alright, let me buff up here for a moment. 1 second. Alright. My fully buffed range is 173k to 192k. It is actually higher than this, but I cannot use Echo as I was recording this before and I messed up, so I'm actually starting over. But unfortunately, Echo has a 2-hour cooldown and I have to go to work, so this is really my only chance to film this, so hopefully I don't mess up too much. but anyway, there's my range. I believe when I was using Echo, my range was 199k. I don't remember what the bottom number was, but yeah. So very drastic improvement. And as you might have noticed here, I am actually using Dark Harmony. Let me go ahead and pull up my stolen skills inventory. I'm using Dark Harmony over Sharp Eyes now because of my inner ability, actually. I was lucky enough to get crit rate plus 15%, and what this means is I'm actually going to be able to use decent sharp eyes, as well as the character card from a marksman, and after the red update for phantoms, I'm going to have a 100% crit rate, which is very awesome. I'm gonna be hitting crits all the time. So, yeah. I can now use Dark Harmony and Sharp Eyes at the same time because of the Nebulite. But anyway, let's go on and move on into my equips. So first things first, my totems. 20 luck, 6 attack, 4 luck, 8 luck, 1 attack. Alright, Crusader Codex, 6 all stats, all skill levels plus 1, and ignores 30% of enemy defense. I actually changed the set effect. I'm currently using the Leaf Reset. Alright, my Ghost Exorcist Badge, 3 all stats, 2 attack. My Hat, 11 attack and 9% luck. Android Heart, 20 all stats, 20 luck. I haven't gotten around to potentialing this or my badge. Currently I'm just waiting for the seals to expire. I locked all my items, I do that all the time, and I totally forgot to potential them first, so my bad. My shoulder, 6 all stats, 3 attack, 9% luck. Earrings, 19% luck. My nose, 8 attack, 2% luck. My metal, 4 all stats, 3 attack. My pocket item, 5 all stats, 5 attack. My cape, 8 attack and 10% luck. My glasses, 4% luck. My cane, 168 attack and 6% total, or no, sorry, 10% total damage. God, I can't talk today. Today is not my day. My card, 9% attack and 6% total damage and 6% crit. I am actually going to change the Nebulite on this. Instead of having 6% crit, I also went ahead and bought an 8% crit Nebulite. So that will give me the final 2 crit points that I need to hit 100% crit, so that's awesome. As for my Evolving Rings, everybody has these, I don't really feel the need to go into them. My Tempest Ring, 6 all stats, 2 attack, 9% luck. My top, 15% luck. I got really lucky cubing this. My glove, as I said, I'm going to be mounting the nebulite on my glove. Actually, tomorrow, I'm waiting for the seal to expire. It expires tomorrow, but the stats right now, 26 attack, 6% luck, and then I'll be mounting the decent SE nebulite on it. My shoes, 27 attack, and 16% luck. Apparently I can't count today. My bottom, 16% luck. My belt, 8 attack and 7% luck. My pendant, 22 all stats and 16% luck, yeah. My mon, 10 attack. And then my Evo rings. And those are my equips, guys. And obviously don't forget about these nebulites that I'll be putting on my equips here soon. So, I've shown you my equips, my range, my inner ability, so now I guess it's time to move on to my link skills. So let's go ahead and do that. Alright, so first things first, obviously Phantom Instinct, this is my Phantom's link skill. Right now it's level 2, and it's 15% crit rate. Alright, let's go to the next one. Pirate Blessing for my Cannoneer, 15 all stats, 5 attack I believe, or no. I guess it doesn't give an attack boost, never mind. Fury Unleashed from my Demon Slayer, 10% boss damage. Luminous Link skill, 10% enemy defense ignore. Kaiser Link skill, HP plus 10%. Xenon Link skill, I actually have this at level 2, and it's 10% all stats. Demon Avenger Link skill is 10% damage, so it's just like Kana's here, 10% damage here. These two are the same. And then finally we have Keen Edge for my Hayato, which is 10 all stats and 5 attack. And then I also have Elven Blessing, which is just 10% experience per kill. And then also Night's Watch from my Mihail, which is basically just a stance effect. And then I also have Terms and Conditions from Angelic Buster, but I never use this because it only lasts like 10 seconds. So I don't really see a need for this. But there's my link skills, and then finally let's move on to my character cards, so be right back guys. Alright guys, it's time to show you guys the character cards that I use, and as you will notice, all three of these are S rank, all three of these are A rank, and all three of these are B rank. And if you keep your cards at the same rank, you actually get a nice little set bonus here, so little pro tip there. But anyway, for deck number 1, I'm using the Xenon card, Kana card, and Battle Mage card. Xenons give 20 strength, dex, and luck. Kana gives 3% damage to bosses. And Battle Mage reduces the damage that you take by 4%. Alright, so for deck... Oh wait, sorry, I'll show you the set bonus. For the 3 S rank set bonus, you get 700 HP and MP, as well as 3 attack and 3% damage on bosses. So that's pretty cool. Alright, for deck number 2, which is this one right here, all A rank, I have Hayato level 70, Angelic Buster level 70, as well as Mercedes level 81. And Hayato's card increases the minimum crit damage by 4%. Angelic Buster gives 20% dex. And the Mercedes card reduces cooldowns by up to 5 seconds or 3%. And then the set bonus for A's is 500 HP and MP as well as 3 attack. Or no, sorry, what am I? Wow, I was looking there. 1 attack, not 3 attack. I wish. Alright, and then for the final deck, the B rank cards. They don't really give much of a set effect, they just give 300 HP and MP. And then I have an Aaron, an Evan, and a Marksman. Can't talk today for some reason. So basically, the Evan and Aaron, their links or their character cards are the same, except Aaron is for HP, Evan is for MP, and basically they act as a drain, and you have a 70% chance to recover 2% max HP or MP with each attack. So that's pretty cool. I guess in a way it kind of reduces the amount of potions that you burn, but it's not extremely noticeable. I think maybe down the road I might level these characters some more, and maybe that'll help, I don't know. And then finally, we have my marksman here. And I'm trying to get this guy to level 70, because after he is A rank, he actually increases your crit rate by 2%, which is exactly what I need for post-red. That way I will have 100% crit. So I'm actually 1% away from 100% crit. So I've been leveling this guy like crazy, along with my Demon Avenger. And Demon Avenger and Marksman are so boring. But I'm doing it just because I need the 1% crit. But anyway, guys, those were all of my character cards, my equips, my inner abilities, and everything else. If I forgot to show you guys anything, please let me know in the comments below. And in the next equip video, I will try to show it to you guys. But thank you guys so very much for watching. Like, favorite, subscribe, comment, and toodles.